in the United States, there are a number of different codes that are out there that, that tell engineers how they should design structures to remain standing. So part of all members of our research team is actually on that committee, and you know, we're trying to get our information into it. There's a couple of empty chapters in ASC 7, and one of them we are now writing on tsunami demands on structures. The concept behind the research project is to look at the effects of debris impact. For you know those people who saw all the footage from the Japan, the Tohoku earthquake in Japan, from all of that damage, you could see a lot of debris that was picked up. In addition to the wave effects, hydraulic effects, hydrodynamic effects, there's this all this massive debris in the water. And the research that we're looking at is how do you design for that debris? You know, if you have this, all these massive pieces of houses, actual vehicles, actual containers coming at a structure and impacting the structure, how do you actually design that structure for that? And actually taking a step back is what force is actually generated by that impact. So what we're doing is we're trying to predict the forces that are being generated by the impact event.
Massive tsunami wave
has issued a warning for tsunami up to 6 meters deep.
More than 15,000 people dead, 130,000 people forced from their homes.
Live coverage of tsunami engulfing.
So many fleeing to rooftops to escape the mountain of debris barreling by.
It was incredible to see that. I mean, the devastation was just unbelievable. You can't imagine. Even the pictures, the videos you see, it just doesn't do it justice until you're standing on the ground. And you look up and you see a sign that's literally maybe 60 feet tall, you know, a big billboard sign, and only the last 5 feet of it is left because the water was 40, 50 feet above where you're standing. And it's just incredible. And nothing is left. You know, you have wood frame construction that's completely gone. And it's amazing to see this firsthand. How do we design evacuation shelters? And that's really where our focus is. You know, we're looking at maybe, you know, Waikiki Beach or something like that, where you're gonna have a lot of people out there and it's flat. You know, there's no real elevation aside from the hotels. So you have to design these structures to actually survive an event. So the trick of what we're trying to do here is come up with the recommendations of what forces you have to design for. And if you have a new region that's being developed that has, you know, is prone to tsunami events, maybe even up in Alaska, some new development is going to be put up, then how do we design that structure? So we're looking at full size, which is difficult to do in the water. There's nowhere you can really do that easily. So we're doing the in-air effects, understanding how this debris works in the lab, what kind of responses it has and how that contributes to the demands. And the whole thing is you can't test everything as a researcher. You do a few tests to develop models, calibrate models that you're confident that they work, and then you can do, you know, thousands of simulations to really understand the phenomenon that's occurring. People have made models, they make them all the time, they still make them all the time. And I've seen many people do just model, and there's not one data point that justifies whether it's right. And whatever, you can make a model do whatever you want. So you have to have the experimental to either prove that it's right at the end or validate the concepts that you're dealing with, or else it's all just make-believe.